Okay, today we're going to talk about the arm waving whirligigs, like this one. They're a little bit tricky. Andy Lund's book. Andy is probably one of the better known whirligig makers, if not writers, in the country today. He has a chapter in this book called Arm Waving Whirligigs. So, arm waving whirligigs can be birds. Quite often in the old days, they were figures of people. And in the famous book, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, they mention a soldier waving his sword in the wind at the top of the barn. And that was an arm waving whirligig. And the reason these are kind of tricky, the blades have to be perfectly level, almost perfectly level, or even with each other. They have to be perfectly balanced. One can't be too heavy, it won't turn. The real tricky part of the arm waving whirligig is the pivot point. Because if the pivot point is too far away from the axle of the wings, then the whirligig's just gonna turn into the wind like this, the wings won't spin. So it's kind of tricky. Andy Lund says it best when he says the relationship between the pivot and the hub is very important. If they are too far apart on an arm waver, the body will turn into the wind and stop the arms from spinning or the wings from spinning. If the hub is right over the pivot point, the body will tend to just continuously spin like this, because one wing will catch the wind, spin it around, and then the next one will. So you have to have it the right distance. And some people even, you know, they'll drill a hole and try it, and it won't work, so they'll move it a little bit. Move it a quarter of an inch or a half an inch one direction or the other to get it just right. When the holes are in the right place, the body will remain sideways to the wind. So I've got the wind coming from a fan over here. So the body will remain sideways to the wind, and it'll spin like that. I'm going to zoom in here and show you, take this apart, the axle apart, and show you how I make this work. There's the axle. This axle is a 3/16 rod. You can use wood or just coat hanger wire, but you know, how easily do you want your wings to turn? How long do you want it to last? How durable do you want it to be? And how much time do you want to spend working on it? I have a 3/16 rod that goes through the body here. And these little extenders on the body, they're just set there to keep the wings from hitting the body or hitting the support post. You're gonna have some kind of a support post on your wherever you put your whirligig. So you don't want the wings to spin down and whack the support post. So I have these little spacers here, and these are about an inch. They were half circles that I sanded one half. I cut them in half, the half circles in two, glued them on the side of the body, and then sanded off a flat spot for the wings to run on. Okay? And then these bushings, I have little brass bushings in there that are 1/4 inch outside diameter and 3/16 inside diameter. So that helps it turn very smoothly. And then, so this axle has to be locked in
to one side, so that it, you know, so that it doesn't just spin on the axle. So I've drilled through the wood here and into the 3/16 rod. I drilled a 1/16 hole and just put a little pin in there with a tight fit. I think it was a little piece of wire or a piece of a screw. It might have been a little sheet metal screw that you could just basically screw down in there to keep that pin permanent. And then you want to have one, the other wing, one wing that's going to be removable. So if you ever have to work on it, you know, if it rusts up or gets damaged, the wing breaks, something like that, you want to have one that you can remove. So on this one, I kind of got fancy. I drilled the hole in the 1/16 rod, and then I had a little tiny tap with a little, I think I got these at a hobby shop from a model railroading setup, but these are tiny little screws. And you certainly don't have to go to this length, but I wanted this to be removable. You could just put a pin in here. What I've done before is just put a pin through there and bend it over to hold it. Just the important thing part is that it's removable, so you can work on your whirligig and fine-tune the action. Okay, so that's what I wanted to show you today. Again, you can make this rod out of, you could put a quarter-inch dowel. You know, and if you kept that out on the wind a lot, that would wear out. I mean, you could grease it. But you could, I've seen these really effectively made with just a piece of wire through here, and the wire bent 90 degrees on each end, and then hooked into a slot in the wing. Real simple and quick. But you don't see these much anymore. I guess it's because of the complexity of the design, and the fact that sometimes if you don't get the pivot at the right point, they don't work. You don't see these. I haven't seen one of these to buy in probably 25 or 30 years. There you have it.